Hey, Henry Kaiser here with the Cuneiform Records YouTube page, Whole Tone Guitar Lesson. Now, a week or so ago, my friend Sean Persinger, another fine, amazing guitarist and a fine Cuneiform Records artist, he did a lesson, a weird guitar lesson on the whole tone scale here on the Cuneiform YouTube page. And he explored how in a tune by his band, Boudin, that he wrote this tune, how he would use the whole tone scale, and the tune particularly had a lot of whole tone scale licks on the first two strings, and kind of that Robert Fripp fracture sound is how most people. Anyway, I thought, well, that's such a nice lesson. Why don't I do a whole tone scale lesson too? And I'll kind of concentrate on the second and third strings instead of the first and second strings. But I'll use as a vehicle for that, I'll teach you Sonny Chirac's tune, Dick Dogs. A great tune that was first on the album Dance With Me Montana. And then it was later on this album here that Bill Laswell produced. It's a great tune. I remember Sonny taught it to me back in 1987 for a gig we had. And I'll tell you a little bit more about that. And I'll tell you a little bit more about Sonny. But why don't we watch Sonny in a Prague Jazz Festival playing the tune Dick Dogs. Okay, here we go. Dick Dogs. We'll be right back. what an amazing guitarist the late Sonny Chirac was, and he became a good friend of mine. This was my first guitar. I bought this on November 1st, 1971, and I went back to my dorm room in college, and I remember putting on Pharaoh Sanders' album Tawhid, which has Sonny Chirac on it, one of the first Sonny Chirac recordings that people heard. And I remember taking a slide and just trying to make sounds with Sonny Chirac of the type of sounds that he was making there. Sonny Chirac was an amazing pioneer. You can look in the links and see his YouTube page and some other history about him. As far as experimental guitar goes, specifically free jazz experimental guitar, Sonny Chirac is the first. He's like the first human footprints on the moon. I always loved his stuff, always close to my heart. And then Bill Laswell had me play in material with him. We did a tour in Europe. Sonny and I did some duo gigs. He did a gig with Invite the Spirit. We had all too short a time together before he died of a heart attack. But let's look at this tune, Dick Dogs. There's basically three licks or parts in the song. First, there's this little funk lick. Right? Okay. And then there's this second little line. Let's do that. I can do it better than that. There we go. Notice when he plays that note, he bends it a little. So that's whole tone scale here on the second and third strings. That's all whole tone scale. And that's jumping up a half step out of the whole tone scale. Little tension device. So in Sean's lesson, the notes are on alternate frets. But that's on the first and second strings. He plays the third string too, but here they're just the second and third frets. So we've got those two licks, and then there's a long connecting downwards lick that's sort of the turnaround of the song. And that just goes all the way down the neck from where the first lick started. So it's one more time, that was sloppy. Then back to the solo. And then Sonny plays around Fred for a while, and then he plays some of his amazing trademark slide playing. He uses usually a steel bar like this steel bar that was my dad's steel guitar that he played steel guitar with. And Sonny plays, holds it in his hand. If you try it with a regular slide and you're trying to go to the regular equal tempered scale pitches, it's wrong. It's a free thing. It's free jazz saxophone screaming. It's John Coltrane, it's John Gilmore, it's Pharoah Sanders. It's a human expression of Sonny's experience. Often turned at an angle so you don't get the notes that are next to each other to get... You'll see in the video he's turning it. So there's different intervals between the strings. Anyway, that's my whole tone lesson. Thanks so much for joining us here, and I hope I can talk another cuneiform guitarist into doing a third whole tone lesson, and a fourth, and a fifth. It just seems like a fun thing to do. Bye-bye. Thanks.